Why is KDE so damn buggy? That question is so commonly asked that if you go to Google and type in why is KDE, the first hit is why is KDE so buggy? The third hit is why is KDE so slow? KDE's buggy reputation goes all the way back to at least 2009 with KDE 4 and 4.5. Now the point of this video is certainly not to bash KDE or point out its flaws or weaknesses. Instead, I want to focus on sort of demystifying the reasoning as to why KDE is perceived to be so buggy or slow. Truth be told, I'm not a KDE user. However, KDE 3.5 was the very first desktop environment for Linux that I used, and if you look at the very first video on this channel, I was using KDE 4.something on OpenSUSE. I don't use KDE as a desktop environment anymore, but I use a fair number of KDE apps such as Kdenlive and Muon. And I greatly appreciate what the KDE team is doing, especially the KDE Neon project. KDE itself is an entire framework of libraries, tools, utilities, and applications. KDE is built on top of Qt, which is also a framework. Now, generally speaking, when people talk about KDE, they're talking about the Plasma desktop. The Plasma desktop is the actual desktop environment portion of KDE and can be compared to the GNOME shell, XFCE, or Unity. And the Plasma desktop itself is comprised of a number of applications and frameworks such as KWin, KIO, Solid, and the Phonon multimedia framework. It's a really, really big desktop environment with a lot of moving parts. And that brings me to the main reason why I feel like KDE is perceived to be so buggy. The keyword is interoperability. The KDE project is massive. Plasma desktop is massive. And every application, library, and framework within the desktop has to play nicely with one another. But KDE applications tend to be so tightly coupled to dependencies and other applications that if you just want to simply install a KDE application, it has to install hundreds of megabytes worth of dependencies just to make that one application work. Now don't get me wrong, tightly coupled dependencies is not necessarily a bad practice, but what it does have a tendency of doing is making it very difficult for a developer to assure that their code is well integrated as part of a general framework. And this is true across any software application. Generally speaking, when you write tests for your code, you don't write tests for the dependencies that your code is using. You just sort of assume that your dependencies are well tested and work properly. The KDE project has its own automated build system, and while it does support automated tests and static analysis, it doesn't appear to enforce anything. And the KDE project itself doesn't appear to enforce any sort of quality standards, such as unit tests or integration tests. KDE applications are just that, they're applications, and it's really up to the developer to decide how to test them and how to integrate them with the rest of the framework. For the most part, it works fine, but occasionally things go wrong and you see bugs and breakages. Let's take Arc for example. Arc is KDE's de facto archive manager. In the root directory for the Arc source code, you have a Travis YAML file. The Travis YAML file is how Travis CI determines how to build and run tests for a given project. And you can see here that they have a whole folder full of tests and tests for different plugins, such as 7-zip, RAR, zips. Now let's take the venerable Dolphin file manager. There doesn't appear to be any sort of CI file at the root directory, but that doesn't necessarily mean there isn't a CI process. The tests for Dolphin make great use of the built-in framework provided by Qt, in using signal spies and queue verifies and compares all over the place. That's fantastic. But if there's no CI process, when do the tests run? Now before CI was a mainstream thing, projects just sort of relied on the developers to run the tests. But as a developer, I can tell you, developers don't always run the tests. So let's take our final example, Kdenlive. Not only is there no indication of CI in the root directory, there doesn't appear to be any tests. Now it's possible that Kdenlive is tested elsewhere and I'm just not seeing it in the source tree, but I'm not seeing any tests at all. There's a folder called testing area and there's a file in here called audio offset, but it's not making use of any of the built-in Qt test framework. I did a quick search in the project for the word test and I didn't find much. Now I'm not saying that Kdenlive is untested, but with both Arc and Dolphin, the tests are at least built into the solution. Kdenlive, if there are any tests, are not built into the solution and are expected to be run elsewhere. And I think that just about wraps it up. Now keep in mind that this is my opinion, and in my opinion, The problem with KDE and the perception that it is buggy is that there are so many moving parts with all of the KDE applications, and the interoperability between the applications is hard. It's hard for developers to coordinate and get all of the applications, libraries, and frameworks to work well with one another. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and if you liked this video and others on my channel, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I know that lots of people have their own opinions and experiences with KDE, so why don't you let me know in the comments section below? And thanks a lot for watching.